he and a lot of other people working with him did was inspire folks across party lines to say that we needed a change in this state, that we could not have somebody like Russell Pearce, who was so out of step with the people of that district, Democrat, Republican, Independent alike, that we needed new responsible leadership. When he did that, he set forward something that has gotten, as we all know, the attention of people all across our nation and inspired people to step forward to continue working towards a better Arizona. That is what all of us here are all about. And I am so proud that Maricopa County and our LDs and so many others helped contribute to that effort. Because this was an effort that, again, was something that was all about a group of people who sometimes have worked together before and sometimes hadn't, coming together around a central cause and a central vision. We live in a better state because of what happened two Tuesdays ago. And so it gives me great pleasure to introduce Randy Parraz. Thank you very much. So I'm Arizona Democrats. How are you feeling today? Feels a little different now living in Arizona, right? Yeah! Well, I want to thank Andre Cherney for your leadership, for bringing us all together, for making these things happen. It's something we all should be celebrating, right? We finally turned the page, finally Arizona in the national headlines for all the right reasons, right? Yeah. Things that we care about. Yeah. I don't know about you, but we're getting messages from all across the country. So I think today is about recognition. It's about recognizing the folks that made it happen. So for those folks who were part of our team of volunteers from the back, Carolyn and Fred and Jeff and other folks, LDA team chair, Andrew, and your folks, your officers, please come forward. Diane Todd Selleck, please come forward. Pat and John, come forward. Marilyn, come forward. And come forward. The folks that, so let's hear it for them. The folks that actually believe in something better for Arizona. Really put their interests aside and fight for what you thought was best. Let's hear it for these folks. I tell you what, you know, Kent Chapman's trying to be all shy back there, but he was part of it. You know, this is a situation. We have people up here, Todd and Diane Selleck right here. These folks live in LD18. We have people up here who were walking in January before we even formed a recall committee. And when we were walking down there, we met at a Safeway. We got some lists. Kent kind of slipped them to us. That's nice. We started talking to people, and our question was just this. We didn't say anything about recall. We knocked on the door and said, "Hi, I'm so-and-so. How do you feel about Russell Pearce being president of the Senate?" Right? That was our conversation. And almost two out of three people said, "Who is Russell Pearce?" We're like, "Oh my God, look what's going on here." Right? People did not know what was going on. So we knew we had a chance, and we moved forward, right? Put them on notice on January 10th, and we moved forward. Gave them a 21-day notice. I know, trying to say, "Look, you know, please tone down your rhetoric." 2 days just after, before, Gabby Giffords was shot down, right? We said, "Tone down your rhetoric, Russell Pearce. Focus on what people care about. On jobs and education and healthcare. Help us lead us to a better day," right? We put him on notice. We didn't say we're gonna recall you. But what did he do after 21 days? What do you think he did? Sorry about talking about nullifying federal laws, right? Sending back $9 million of healthcare for poor people, right? Closing down Medicaid. Kicking people off of access. Talking about the Constitution, changing the 14th Amendment. Birthright, citizenship, you say, so extreme that agenda, right? So we came back with the courage of someone like Todd Selleck signing that recall petition on January 31st. Almost 100 people walked into the Secretary of State's office and said, "Russell Pearce, you're recalled." And this is how it began. So I want to thank you all for hanging in there. I know there's a lot of folks out there who gave some money early on to support our effort. Because I know, I mean, a lot of folks didn't believe, right? They thought, "You ain't got a chance. Russell Pearce is too powerful. Russell Pearce will come after you. Russell Pearce will hold up your legislation. Russell Pearce will do things that you don't want to see happen. We're not going to get involved in this thing." And so look what could happen. Right? The dream was that within a year's time, Russell Pearce would not be president of the Senate, and now we have a dream fulfilled, right? Because people believe in it. And also, there are other, I want to thank Democrats, right? There's Democrats, there's LD chairs, there's CJ Briggle, I know Sandra, Eric Shelley from LD 7, my home district.
Randy Keating,
yes. I want to thank folks, if I don't mention any, I apologize, but Democrats helped make this thing happen. Activists, people, lifelong Democrats came up and put their, especially Freddie, and said, he put his party thing aside and said, I will work to get Jerry Lewis elected if it means getting rid of Russell Pearce. It was a bigger vision of what it took to happen. And I think I want to remind people that even when we got to the Jerry Lewis stage, this was never about Jerry Lewis, because he didn't exist when we started this recall. This was all about Russell Pearce, and then it became all about us. And so together, we came together and made this thing happen. So I want to thank everyone for that work. I also want to recognize some of our other members of our team for Citizens for a Better Arizona. Billy Alvarez, who's a co-founder in the back, co-founder and director of fundraising, which we'll get to in a second. We have Sarah Ryan, who's our office manager with volunteers. Sarah, stand up over here. We really kept things going. They kept that office moving, kept it going very well. And we have Ruth, who's also interning with us over there, just started working with us on this effort. Now, I want to point something out because
LD 18 wants to put forth a challenge to every other LD in Arizona. We're sending $100 to Citizens for a Better Arizona, and we challenge every other LD to do the same thing.
Thank you. If anyone else wants to interrupt me, you can. All right, Janie Hydrick, thank you very much. And like I said, anyone else wants to interrupt with those types of things, I'll be more than happy to yield the mic. What's that going? Also, I want to speak to this too, because a lot of folks, you know, at the national level are taking credit, and that's fine. But they want to make this thing, there's something called the recall, right? Which is the initial process to get the signatures, raise them, and turn that in, right? And then there's actually the election of Jerry Lewis. And at that stage, about 6 to 8 weeks out from the election, a lot of folks did come on. Thank God they did. Promise Arizona in Action, focus on Latino vote. Public campaign and to help with the mailers and getting that out there. Other groups came to the table. Mi Familia Vota, other folks came out to help us, and we thank you for that, right? But I want to, and then I want to acknowledge, and all young Latino activists came out then too. But when we started this, there were no national immigration groups watching this. There were no very unions were watching, except for CWA and Paul Castaneda, state council, who contributed this. People were just kind of watching this. The demographic I want to salute are people 50 and over. You know, mostly white folks that came out, and I'm being honest here, and carried the day. We're knocking on doors, collecting the signatures, helping us raise money. Give yourselves a round of applause. You all made this thing happen. This is the folks that made this thing happen. Right? And I know we need young people to get involved, but I tell you what, your values, what you fought for all your life, you put it on the line out in LD18. Right? Some of you are retired, some of you spent your whole life as an educator, and seeing what's taking place here in Arizona, you said, you know what, this is the fight for me. So I thank you for that on behalf of Citizens for Arizona. I thank you all for the work you're doing. We're asking you, some of you were asking you to do your penance now. I know you probably haven't contributed yet. This is your chance to say, no, this is something you should have given back then, but you can give now, make your checks up for Citizens for a Better Arizona. We have folks that can collect that. But again, we're going to take this and we're going to move forward at 12 o'clock on Monday at the Capitol. We're inviting you all to join us. We're going to be announcing a new campaign. Because there was somebody who was very visible during the downfall of Russell Pearce. And I think you all know his name. All right. Hey, hey, ho, ho. Sheriff Joe's got to go. All right. So people are saying, what's your money going to be used for? It's going to be used for another historic campaign. We're going to start putting the idea, we're going to start to imagine Maricopa County. I know it's hard for you all, been here all your lives. Not having Sheriff Arpaio as your sheriff. I know. So it's not going to be, a whole recall for Sheriff Arpaio. It's going to be really holding him accountable, saying, Sheriff Arpaio, are you going to pick up the baton that Russell Pearce just dropped that represented extremism and hatred and division? Are you going to pick that up? Are you going to leave it there? Or are you going to change your behavior? We've already asked him this question a couple of times. We're going to come back to that. And right now he's dodging us. He just sent out a mailer that quoted us in it saying, this extreme left-wing folks are now coming after me. Right?
Yes.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are. Yes, we are.